ash cash. I keep on getting them flashbacks. I was OT, so I had to bash. I'm almost thought about getting a cab back. Do it like recon video that if we upload it, probably get some backlash. Backshot, she got the ripple effect. That she handle it, this one talented. Pum pum soaking, feel like I'm paddling. Back come round, I'm a fan of it. Ride on a bike one time and saddle it. Ayo, a doctor working wonders. Damn, that's a big circumference. Get her wet, she don't need no lube. On the 40th floor, you should see the view. She don't wanna send me a pussy on Snapchat, madman. I don't wanna leak your nudes.
Yes, my people. Thanks for tuning in on another episode with Bam the Petrol Head. And on today's episode, we got this beautiful Ford Fiesta ST. Hashtag game over, guys. This here is not your standard car. I know it looks like one, but underneath that bonnet, there's some real fire there. This is Brad's car. It's absolutely fire. He's got some amazing mods, guys. So stay tuned in. We got some real fire coming for you. Yes, my people. So this is the guy behind the car. This is Brad, guys. So what's good?
Hi, guys. My name's Brad. This is my ST-200. I've gone for the standard look of it, but it's far from standard.
Trust me.
Surprises a lot of people. The sunstrip explains itself.
Game over. Come on. So, yes, yeah. Guys. Like, literally, we're going to jump into this one here. Yes, so right now we're under the bonnet of Brad's beautiful ST. And Brad, what did he actually run standard then?
So standard, you've got the ST-180s, which run 180 brake horsepower. And then this one's the ST-200, so it runs 200 brake from standard.
Okay.
Slightly more tuned from factory.
Yeah.
So
how much BHP is on this one?
So this one supposedly is running between 340 to 360. It hasn't been on the dyno yet. But that is the figures I was told.
Okay, what like mods have you done to get it so high then?
So currently it's a running a stage 3 setup with the X47R hybrid turbo.
Oh, big.
Yeah, so obviously got all the supporting mods around it, like the induction hoses, crossover, the ITG induction kit. It's all the supporting mods you need.
You never missed that nothing on this one then, full blown.
Yeah, no, it's got the stage 3 intercooler.
Yeah.
So, yes.
You're ready for action.
Yeah, it's ready.
Literally. Yeah, so another cool mod I love on this is the bonnet. Like, so tell us a bit about that. Did you do that yourself or? So
the bonnet vents, I did myself. No, I'm joking. I took it to the man, Ian Newell. So shout out to Ian Newell.
That, he done a good job. That's looking nice.
He done bits for it.
Come on. And it actually does vent.
Yeah, they're proper vent. So the main reason behind it was obviously it's running big power, so it was just to cool down the turbo a bit quicker.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So the sunstrip, guys, I did myself, and the reason behind the game over is just it's game over. a lot of people try and race me and
end up getting gaps,
so it's game over.
Come on guys, don't underestimate him. Yes, guys, so right now we're at the back of this beautiful Ford ST. And obviously the exhaust does look standard, but it's not. I'll let Brad explain that for you guys.
So with the exhaust, guys, it's a full Miltef exhaust, the sport race. It's got a back box on it just to quieten it down a little bit. It's got a sports cat in it as well, Miltef sports cat. So yeah, it's all Miltef already.
You heard them, guys. It's not like his old ones, as you'll explain later.
Yes,
he came a long way from the straight pack days. Look what I've just spotted. It's a shitbox. Come on, guys. You gotta love a shitbox. Yes, guys. So another little cool feature he has on his car here is this boost gauge. This is so cool. I've never seen a boost gauge like this. It's literally fitted like it's from factory. Tell us a bit about that.
So this boost gauge is it's made in America. It's like an American style boost gauge. Tells you all sorts of things you need to know. So at the moment it's set on boost. You can press this button, it'll go over to your coolant temperature.
Okay,
so that'll tell you your coolant temperature. Press it again, it'll tell you air. So that's the air. Ignition.
Yes, it's good. What was it like? It was probably like a hassle fitting in, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a hassle wiring it up and fitting it, but we always get the job done.
Yeah, and it's definitely worth it.
Yeah.
Definitely worth it. Was it a lot of them or?
I paid around $550 for it.
Okay,
so yeah, it's not too bad.
Yeah.
It was just a pain fitting it.
Yeah.
It was worth it in the end. So it tells you your speed, like a digital speedo as well.
Okay, yeah, that's cool, so, man, yeah.
And it's also, which is the most fun one, it does 0 to 100 times.
Okay, cool. So, might have to use that one today.
That's the best one.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
That's cool.
Yes, guys, so we're out in our first drive. It's mad. One thing I love on this is that induction kit. It really does sound crazy. So what induction kit are you putting that then?
So it's running the ITG induction kit. Yeah. It sits behind the headlight.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's
massive, isn't it?
Yeah, it's an amazing air filter, to be fair.
Yeah. Top quality, you can really hear it. It makes it sound so much more clearer. So like, how long have you had this car?
So I've had the car around about 3 months. Uh-huh. It's my third car now.
So what's your previous cars?
So my first car when I first passed my test was the Mark 6 Fiesta Celebration Edition.
Okay.
I had that car for about a year and a half. And then I got the Mark 8 Fiesta 1 litre.
Yeah.
Just didn't cut it for me.
Obviously, this is a big difference from the 1 litre.
So yeah, I decided to get this. I like the limited edition cars. Mm. I like the rare cars.
Who doesn't?
So I thought, yeah, why not go for that?
Yeah. It was definitely a good option, and with what you've done with it, all the mod you've done with that engine is absolutely amazing.
Yeah, it's different.
Definitely.
I like different.
So you're definitely a Ford guy though, that's good, that's
yeah,
fair to say.
Yeah, I like Fords. they surprise people.
Yeah, they do, definitely. After being in this one, like, it definitely is surprising the way it blows.
Yeah.
Especially for, you know, when you see an ST, you don't really, you know, think, you know, it has about 300 brake.
Nah. Amount of cars that try it with me, and again, hashtag game over.
Hashtag game over.
So,
just straight. Okay, guys, so right now he's gonna give me a second gear pull. Why? Woo! Yes, bro. Yes. Yes, bro. This moves. This moves. It moves. It moves. Wow. It moves. I did not know about these STs like this. They move. Boy. His grip swelled. Definitely them STs helped out. Boy. Yes, it's proper. That it moves. I give it that. It definitely moves, guys. This is not a joke. It had me holding on. It had me holding on. Boy. And that exhaust as well, it sounds amazing.
Yeah, the exhaust is good. It's not too loud,
yeah,
it's subtle.
And you don't need it too loud as well. You don't need it.
It's a subtle noise. It's nice.
And the intercooler as well at the front, it just all adds up, you know what I mean? It all just goes so well together. Another thing I really do love about this is the seats, like, cause it's definitely an upgrade from the standard, isn't it?
Yeah, mate, they're the ST-200 seats, so they all come in black. They definitely keep you comfy, they hug you.
They definitely hug you.
Yeah.
I feel tucked in.
They're very secure.
So about, you said you got the diffs?
Yeah, I forgot to mention earlier, it's also got the Quaife slip LSD diff, which also comes in very handy.
Definitely.
So yeah, that was a very good purchase.
You need it when you're running that kind of power.
Yeah, it definitely helps put down the power. A lot of people don't expect it.
What is it like with the grip then? Like, is it all right taking off, or does it?
So yeah, like when
in sport.
Yeah, in
like...
sport mode, it's different. it does its own thing. But without the diff, it would be a lot worse. But yeah, it's a great little thing. Helps out a lot on the roads, especially when it's wet.
Yeah, but it's really fun to drive, I bet.
Yeah, it's very fun.
It's crazy.
So yes.
Yeah, it's proper. Yes, my people. Thanks for watching today's episode with Bam the Petrolhead. And big shout out to Brad for coming on the channel. My first Ford is absolutely crazy, guys. And he's done an amazing build with this one. I wish him all the best in the future, guys. 350 on a, you know what I mean, on an ST Ford Fiesta. It's crazy. I'll leave it to Brad.
So thanks for watching, guys. If you'd like to like, subscribe and follow, that would be appreciated. And if you'd like to follow the Instagram, it's at ST200Brad. That would also be very appreciated.
Guys, go hit him up on Instagram. You heard him. Thanks for watching.
I'm giving my lady some driving lessons in a 100 grand G. When you see me in public, no photos, man, I need some privacy, please. Good girl, she just sat on my face, now she's saying her legs are gon' weak. Bad, bad, see the Jake's outside, now I'm flushing the water down the toilet. Mad, mad, rich Amelia crib by the port, and it's important. Sad, sad, if you knew the truth about that nigga, then it would get awkward. And I know that nigga get money, now I know.